These AI robots can now move even faster than humans, as Figure AI just released the second demo of its newest Helix AI system packed with 4 new tech breakthroughs plus a special bonus. But how close to AGI are they now, and what can they do as a result? To answer that, Figure tested Helix's System 1 visuomotor control in several real-world scenarios, demoing the following 4 new tech breakthroughs. Number 1. Implicit Stereo Vision. The first important intelligence feature of the Helix S1 is its adoption of implicit stereo vision, giving the system a rich, three-dimensional understanding of its environment. And unlike its predecessor, which relied on monocular visual input, the upgraded S1 uses a stereo vision backbone paired with a multiscale feature extraction network. This architectural shift allows the robot to merge visual data from 2 cameras into a cohesive, depth-aware picture before processing it through a cross-attention transformer. The result is the robot's exceptional ability to perceive fine environmental details while also maintaining a broader understanding of the scene, such as the layout of a bustling conveyor belt in a factory. To prove this, the robot's stereo vision capability was put to the test in Figure's logistics demo, with packages of varying sizes, shapes, and weights streaming across a conveyor belt, requiring precise depth perception to grasp and reorient them correctly. And the data from these tests showed a 60% increase in throughput compared to non-stereo baselines, with the system even generalizing to flat envelopes that it wasn't explicitly trained on. And this human-like spatial awareness serves as a key visual foundation to enable the next breakthrough that Helix has to offer. Number 2. Multiscale visual representation. This second major advancement builds on top of Helix's stereo vision foundation, allowing Helix S1 to capture both granular details and high-level contextual cues simultaneously. Plus, rather than processing images from each camera independently, the system fuses stereo inputs into a multiscale stereo network, producing a compact set of visual tokens that feed into the transformer without increasing its overall computational load. This balance of detail and context enables more reliable control, whether the robot is picking up a tiny parcel or navigating a crowded workspace. And in the logistics use case, this capability is invaluable because packages on a conveyor belt often vary wildly, with some items being small and rigid, while others might be large and deformable, forcing the robot to decide the optimal grasp point and method on the fly. But the new multiscale approach ensures Helix doesn't lose sight of the bigger picture while zeroing in on critical specifics, like a shipping label's orientation. And the results show that the addition of multiscale feature extraction significantly boosts the effective throughput, referred to as TF, which is a metric that compares the robot's package handling speed to human package handling speed. All of this enables the next great leap in robot intelligence. Number 3. Learned visual proprioception. This third breakthrough tackles another long-standing challenge in robotics, which is successfully scaling a single policy across multiple humanoid robots. This is partially because hardware variations like slight differences in sensor calibration or joint responses can disrupt performance when a policy trained on one robot is applied to another. And while manual calibration used to be the traditional fix, it just doesn't scale for an entire fleet. But Helix S1 sidesteps this with a self-calibration system that estimates the 6-dimensional poses of its end effectors, such as its hands, using only onboard visual input, with no external tools required. As a result, this feature allows Figure to deploy the same policy trained on a single robot across multiple units, with minimal performance drop. And despite small hardware quirks, the robots demonstrate consistent dexterity, flipping packages to expose labels and transferring them between conveyors at high speed. Importantly, this cross-robot transfer capability slashes downtime and calibration costs to make large-scale deployments feasible. But what comes next pushes Helix into superhuman territory. Number 4. Sport Mode. This fourth breakthrough catapults Helix S1 into faster-than-human territory by using a simple yet ingenious test time technique, where Figure speeds up the robot's actions by resampling its output action chunks, which are sequences of movements generated at 200 Hz. For example, a chunk representing a 1-second trajectory can be compressed to 0.8 seconds and executed at the original rate, yielding a 20% speed boost without retraining the model. In testing, Figure pushed this to a 50% speed up, achieving a TF value greater than 1, meaning the robot outpaced its human demonstrators. And sport mode enables Helix's AI to handle packages with incredible efficiency, maintaining high success rates even as throughput soared. However, the demo also showed that while a 50% speedup maximizes performance, pushing beyond this upper threshold sacrifices precision and requires frequent resets. But the demo still highlights a tantalizing prospect: humanoid robots that don't just match human speed but surpass it, all while retaining the dexterity needed for complex tasks like label orientation. And here's why it all matters so much. These advancements, stereo vision, multiscale representation, visual proprioception, and sport mode, aren't just incremental upgrades, but a paradigm shift. By solving core challenges like depth perception, contextual awareness, fleet scalability, and speed, Figure has unlocked a future where humanoid robots can seamlessly integrate into human workflows. The logistics demo is just the beginning. These generic improvements to Helix S1 will enhance every use case Figure pursues, from manufacturing to healthcare. And the numbers back up the hype. A TF above 1.1 means Helix is already 10% faster than its human trainers in some scenarios, with sport mode pushing that edge further. What's more is that the stereo model's 60% throughput jump, coupled with the proprioception module's cross-robot consistency, both signal that this technology is ready for prime time. As for price, Figure AI's CEO suggests their AI robots are already generating revenue, possibly at a premium for early adopters like BMW. But for broader markets, such as logistics or home use, economies of scale could eventually push the price closer to $50,000 as production ramps up, aligning with Adcock's vision of deploying 100,000 robots in the next 4 years. But another price strategy may be a subscription-based model, which could make humanoid robots even more accessible. This could allow businesses and consumers to just pay a monthly fee in a leasing structure instead of a purchasing model. Along this trajectory, Figure might follow the robotics as a service model, where they'd essentially rent out robots for tasks like warehouse sorting or package handling, with pricing based on hours of use or tasks completed. And beyond this, Figure would also potentially maintain ownership of the data, which they could monetize and then pass down savings to users, lowering the entry barrier for smaller firms and consumers, while ensuring more predictable revenue for Figure. And if BMW and other enterprise clients are already seeing value, Figure could even introduce tiered pricing, offering premium AI capabilities, faster updates, or dedicated support at higher subscription levels. Anyways, tell us how much you'd be willing to pay for one of these robots in the comments below, and click here to listen to Figure's CEO talk about his plans for 2025 and beyond.